Okay, today we are going to learn about how to achieve the right articulation in the target language. So, we all know that human activity involves some form of direct or indirect communication affecting both personal and professional life. In a way, it means sharing of information or something to be made known as the situation demands. It is the key of the 21st century, which calls for creativity and credibility. So by creating an atmosphere of thirst in a conversation or text, you add credibility to the message. This can be achieved by a clear and striking tone, which indicates that the information you are discussing contains the right information. Now, to know this, we must also know that what constitutes language. Now, language is a conventional way where members of a particular group or community communicate either through spoken form or written form, consisting of the use of words, sentences in a given structured way. So it's a tool to express ideas and thoughts, and we also know that no two persons can speak alike. Now, why it is important? In most accounts, the primary purpose of language is to facilitate communication in a sense of transmission of information from one person to another. Now, what is distinctive in one language may not be distinctive in another, or may be used in a different way. Now, the language is so important that if you are unable to communicate, is akin to living with a serious impairment. Now, it's very difficult and near impossible to adapt and get along with people if there is no way to communicate with one another. So, thus, language acts as a great porous in communication and removes misunderstandings and mistranslations. Now, this 7 C's, as shown in the chart below, it helps in developing communication skill. Like, we must have these points in our mind when we communicate. One is, it should be clear, it should be correct, it should be concise, it should be concrete, coherent, it should be courteous, and the message what you convey, it should be complete. Now, we all interact with various kinds of people on daily basis. So, a normal human being can learn and speak one or more language. But this communication is a skill and ability that should be acquired by training. Now, we all play roles. Then the role play may shift from intrapersonal to interpersonal communication, both verbally and non-verbally, and the context may have a wide range, like formality versus informality, communication within and outside an organization with the same or different language, geographic space, socio-political background, religious and ethnic belief. The effectiveness of communication results in the communication, in the common understanding between two persons. So there are certain elements which needs to be kept in mind during the communication process, such as proper coding and decoding of message, minimizing the noise, okay, and the desired feedback, which actually determine the quality of the communication. Now, any hindrance in any of those elements can lead to communication background. And we all know that on an average, a human being spends 70 to 80% communicating interpersonally with various stakeholders. Now, we must understand what is the distinction between articulation and pronunciation. Now, articulation, which refers to the individual movement of speech organs such as tongue, jaws, lips, your vocal cord, in order to produce the sounds. It is about the manner in which sounds such as vowels and consonants is produced with the assistance of speech organs and the airflow. Now what is pronunciation? Now pronunciation refers to the way the words needs to be sounded when speaking. That is how syllables of a word need to be pronounced, focusing on the rhythm, stress and intonation. Thus, the control of the flow of air and the shape of the mouth are the keys to clear pronunciation. Now, we come to know about how to improve this articulation. First one is phonetic drill. Learn the phonics of language through phonetic symbols. Every language has a specific set of vowels and consonants. Know the point, that is where the articulators come to meet to produce a sound, and the manner how it is produced. Okay, sound is produced. Now it is one of the valuable tool in learning the sound system of the target language. Now thus, this learning the sounds will help one to find the pronunciation of unfamiliar words in a dictionary too. The second one is auditory reinforcement. Perceptual and productive language skills can be strengthened through listening and speaking activities, and the learners can be aware of where their trouble are in articulating. So the traditional method of listening and repeat approach to communicative language teaching is a good technique to improve the spoken form. Now one can consider the minimal pairs, okay, which have a different meaning, either in isolation, that is at a word level, or in context, that is a sentential level. So here we have some examples like labiodental sounds, fa and va, as in fan versus van. And we have velar sounds like ka and ga, as in back and bag. Vowels such as e and e, as in desk and disc. A and a, as in wet and weight. The next one is visual reinforcement. Now, real-time visual displays helps the learners to develop the sense of the relationship between the patterns they produce. Now, one of the possible convention for making the word stress visible is writing the stress syllable in capital letters. I give you some examples like in fashion, session, behave. Now you can see the bold syllables, they take the stress marker. English, like other Indian language, is a stress language. Therefore, practice through oral repetition, drills and tapping themselves, learners will find it easy to know how the patterns of intonation, stress and rhythm work in a language. The fourth one is tactile reinforcement. One of the forms of this reinforcement includes placing your fingers in the vocal cord, in the throat, okay, in order to feel the vibration of the vocal cords, and it is useful in learning the distinction between voiced and voiceless consonants. For example, I say labial sound, pa, which is voiceless, and ba, which is voiced. Okay, you can feel the voiceless here. Now, the fifth point is audio feedback. Now, tape recorders act as an aid to enhance in two ways. One, for listening to the recorded native speaker discourse, and the second, for taping one's own voice and replaying one's own production. So that way also one can enhance the articulation. The last point is multimedia enhancement. Now multimedia enhancement, such as video recorders, may both serve as a source of learning material and feedback. Students may not only view the native speaker's production of speech, but also can see and hear themselves if it is videotaped. Now I take here from my teaching experience, I take some of the sounds which I find often my students mispronounce. For example, the word park. When I say this park, okay, students often use this insertion of vowel and they say parak. Similarly, the consonant sequence la, la and ba, la. They have bala. then similarly you can find all this sound, all these words which you know have a different articulation. There are no shortcuts to perfect pronunciation. However, there are some ways where you can practice more effectively and improve your skill faster. Now, the first point is listen to yourself. Now, hear pronunciation errors in your own speech. Now, you must be aware of how you speak. The second one is slow down. Okay, your speech should have a medium rate of speech. That is, it should be neither too fast nor too slow. Then picture it. Now close your eyes and think about how to make a sound before saying it. The fourth one is watch yourself. Now you can stand in front of a mirror and see the placement of your articulators. The second one is practice alone. Now, problems are there because we don't speak. The more you speak, the more you get refined. Find a language buddy. That's one of the easiest way to learn a language. That is, you always try to speak with someone who is interested in speaking to you. Even though you don't find, just go ahead and speak. Then pay attention to intonation and stress. Now, pronunciation is more than mastering the sounds. Last, you can sing a song. It helps to relax and just get those words out, as well as helping your rhythm and intonation as well. Now, what are the benefits of knowing a language? Now, learning a language is not just learning the grammar and vocabulary. It empowers one to express one's own thought and ideas or action in the most significant way with clarity, precision, and accuracy. Now, how does good articulation empower a professional? It creates more positive attitudes and less prejudice. Second, good articulation make an employee more valuable in the workplace. And third, it provides a competitive edge and one can participate more effectively and responsibly in a multicultural world. To wind up, give each of these tips a try next time you have a chance and find out which of the which of these tips works best for you. Remember, none of them we mentioned is a quick fix. Okay, but they will really help you to reach your goals as you go on practicing.